really brilliant feeling for me. I don't know if it was brilliant overall, but it was brilliant for me because it became, it did everything I wanted it to. It really let me have some distance to all this I-ness, and it really made all the poems about me interchangeable with the poems about other people. So we all got to kind of, I got to hide in the midst of this. One of the stories that I needed a little distance in telling was the story of my brother, which is the story of November. So the quick story, you know, again, we're going to descend into the down, we're going to go on a little down, and then we're going to come back up later. The story of my brother is he went missing when he was 18 and I was 14. And what happened, he was missing for about 6 months. He went to the bar with his friends, and he got a little inebriated, as we sometimes do when we go to the bar, especially when we're 18. And then my hypothesis is that he tried to cross the river that wasn't frozen and fell in. The tragedy of this was not only his death, but the fact that at the time it wasn't really paid attention to. We tried to get a lot of media attention, and we didn't have much luck with that because of where we were, because of who he was. He was a young Indigenous man from the wrong side of the tracks in the river. What's neat for me is that now that this book has received so much blessed attention that I still can't wrap my brain around, now his story is quite well known to people, and I find that amazing. Because it's all we can do is honor these people, right? These people that we lost, and all we can do is tell their stories and hope people will listen. So this is a little bit of November. Picture. One. In the front hallway, his sister watches him tie his shoes, a foot propped on a small stool. He wears jeans the color of snow, a jacket blue and thin, even though it is such a cold November. He wears a black concert t-shirt, bright writing with an eagle clutching a large peace sign in its claws. Two. He tosses and feathers his soft black hair with thin brown hands, checks his reflection in the mirror. His sister asks him to borrow a sweater. He hesitates, teases, finally says, "Fine." He turns at the door, smirks, and waves. The wind pushes his hair over his face, and he is gone. Three. Her mother picks several pictures to put in the newspaper, different ones showing different things, multiple profiles. But the newspaper takes the one with his hat hung low, half his face in shadow. The headline reads, "Native man missing after binge." She cuts it in two, folds it in two. She cuts it out, folds it in two, puts it in the photo album. She thinks he would like it that they called him a man. Okay, one more. Because I always like to bring it up a little.